Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the safe way of performing laparoscopic cholecystectomy. One of the safe ways is that you have to use cholangiography, and cholangiography you can perform with the ICG. So let us see how to do. You will take 1 mg ICG, that is in 1 ml, and you will inject IV 45 minutes before the surgery. So here this patient has cholelithiasis with cholecystitis, and we are injecting the ICG intravenous 45 minutes before the procedure. And you can use same IV cannula for the infusion and for the fluid also. And after that you can fix the cannula so that patient don't need the next prick. And let us start and now go to the OT. Patient will be anesthetized. We are using nitrous oxide and isoflurane anesthesia. And patient is fully anesthetized and relaxed. 2 Elise forceps will be applied either side. 1/11 number of knife will be taken, and 1 stab wound will be given over the inferior crease of umbilicus. Then you can have the varus needle, and just by lifting the abdominal wall, perpendicular to the abdominal wall but oblique to the muscle, you will introduce the varus needle with the 2 click sound. After that we have to perform, this is irrigation test followed by suction test and then hanging drop test. These tests are essential to recognize that your varus needle is in appropriate place. And after that you will attach the tubing of the insufflator. And here we are using the CO2 warmer together with the insufflator tubing. And you will start the flow rate according to the principle, that is preset pressure is 15 and actual pressure is slowly rising, and initial flow rate is 1 liter per minute. After approximately 1 liter of the gas going in, you can increase the flow rate to 3 liter per minute. And you have to wait till the preset pressure and actual pressure become equal. And here we can see it is now equal. And then you will enlarge the incision. Incision will be enlarged to approximately 11 mm. This is a Scandinavian technique we are using here, and this is a smiling incision over the inferior crease of umbilicus. After that the trocar will be held like a pistol. Head of the trocar should rest over the thenar eminence, and you will dilate the obliterated vitreointestinal tract with a mosquito forceps. Now this is the trocar, you will hold it like a pistol, and by a screwing movement trocar will be introduced inside the abdomen, supporting it by the left hand, and then slowly you will enter. Then take the trocar out and attach the tubing again, and the telescope will be introduced inside. Now another port is just below the GPS sternum and left to the midline, and this is also 11 mm. This is for clip applicator, that's why 11 mm is required. And initially you will go perpendicular, and after that you will pierce the falciform ligament to enter right to the falciform. Now the third port will be introduced, mid clavicular line. just below the fundus of the gallbladder or below the costal margin. So this epigastric port is your right hand port, which you should do initial diagnostic laparoscopy, and slowly the patient head is up and right is up. The anesthetist with the remote, he can put the head up and right up. Now this is the third port, which will produce the midclavicular line, and this will be your left hand instrument. And now fourth port, 7.5 cm lateral and 7.5 cm below in the anterior axillary line. This port will be for the fundus grasper. You can put it like a suicidal knife position. You can introduce this port. Now one grasper will be introduced from the fourth port, and you will hold the fundus of the gallbladder, and fundus of the gallbladder will push towards the tip of the right shoulder. After that, left hand will hold the Hartmann pouch, and the first step of the surgery is adhesiolysis. These are flimsy peritoneal adhesions with the duodenum, which you can push it down and you can strip the duodenum away from the those adhesions. In this particular case, there is no rovier sulcus visible, so you will give anteromedial traction, and then you can start dissecting the posterior peritoneum above the mouth of the elephant. That is, the posterior peritoneum will be dissected, keeping Teflon jaw of the harmonic towards the gallbladder is very safe. That will not allow any vibration to transfer to the gallbladder, and there will be no any puncture of the gallbladder, no bile leak. This is closed type of rovier sulcus here, and this is the posterior peritoneum is separated by giving anteromedial traction. Now this is anterolateral traction, and which will open the anterior peritoneum of this area to make a posterior window. You can strip some of the peritoneum of the cystic pedicle to skeletonize the cystic pedicle. A stripping of the peritoneum should be down, visceral peritoneum should be stripped down so that it won't create tenting of the CVD. Now this is the posterior window which is created, and that should be enlarged. That is a window which is in between the cystic artery, and inferior surface of the liver should be visible. Now the safest way of doing the cholecystectomy, that when you just strip the peritoneum, after that you should use the platelet, peanut. And this is how you will do with the harmonic your dissection. Right hand has a atraumatic long jaw grasper, left hand, and right hand has a harmonic. After that, this is the peanut, and with the peanut you will make a posterior window wider. That will make it sure, use of peanut will make it a lot of safety. This is platelet made by Ethicon company, and it is beautiful instrument for the blunt dissection. You can strip the peritoneum, you can strip this common hepatic duct, you can strip the right and left hepatic duct, and the visceral peritoneum over the cystic pedicle also will be stripped out. It will swab the blood also, if any, and then it will get a good plane of dissection for Maryland now to make a window in between the artery and the duct. We can see this is the Maryland dissecting, opening the jaw in between the artery and duct. So the calotte triangle is defined. We can clearly see the critical view of safety, and this is little more skeletonization around the cystic duct and artery can be carried out. So critical view of safety, where you should clearly see two structures going towards the gallbladder, and you should have the two windows which is clearly visible. Inferior surface of the liver is visible, and approximately 1/3 of the gallbladder is separated from the bed of the gallbladder. So we can see here anteromedial traction is showing the inferior surface of the liver, and at that point there is no any structure going into the liver. And this is the artery, here is the artery, and this is a window in between the artery and duct. So this is the skeletonization over. Now another important safety feature to perform safe laparoscopic cholecystectomy is that you will switch the camera to the ENV mode. And this is ENV mode, you can see the infrared light is augmented, and here clearly every structure is visible. This is cystic duct, below is the CBD, and above this is the common hepatic duct. And all these structures are clearly visible. So this is one of the most safe way of performing the laparoscopic cholecystectomy. So now this is the every structure, this is right and left hepatic duct going into the liver, which is clearly visible, right and left hepatic duct. And this is CBD, and this is common hepatic duct. So all the structures are clearly visible. This is common hepatic, this is the cystic duct, and here it is CBD. So you will identify this is one of the safest way of performing laparoscopic cholecystectomy. Before clipping the cystic duct and cystic artery, you should define all the structure, and this is only possible if you will do the cholangiography. And nowadays all the good camera, they have the fluorescent imaging technology, and they can give you the different modes like iris mode or ENV mode, and you can confirm the cystic duct and CBD. Now this is the clip, titanium clip, which is clipping the cystic artery. So two clips are applied over the artery. And then we will apply three clip over the cystic duct. The distance between first and second is 3 mm, and between second and third is 6 mm. So all the clips are in the position. After that, either with the scissors or harmonic scalpel, you can bring and you can cut the artery and duct. Harmonic is a scalpel, so it can easily cut the artery and duct. First the artery is cut and followed by duct. Now you have to give anteromedial, anterolateral traction, and the gallbladder will be separated from the liver. First cutting the peritoneal folds so that you can get a good areolar tissue plane. Anteromedial means neck of the gallbladder should be pushed towards the GFE sternum, which will open the left peritoneal fold. And then anterolateral traction, which will open the right peritoneal fold. Without cutting the peritoneum, going to attempt to separate the gallbladder from liver will often puncture the gallbladder. Once half of the gallbladder is taken, then the light cable is down here. 30 degree telescope light cable is down, and it will show you up, and that will give you the beautiful view of the plane of dissection. And slowly the entire gallbladder with a good areolar plane should be separated. Sometime you can hold the fundus of the gallbladder also, and you can pull it inferoanterior traction. Now this is reached up to the fundus part of the gallbladder is reached. Now this is the final, only little part is attached. So before cutting this final part, you should have a look again of the cystic pedicle, because after that your traction will be lost. So have a look, go nearer, and again you can switch on the ICG mode and you can see cystic duct is visible, common hepatic duct is visible, CVD is visible, and little dye is taken by the liver also, which is visible. So all the structures are clearly visible, no bleeding, no any bile leak, no duct of Lusca, no cystohepatic duct, and after that final detachment of the gallbladder from the liver will be done. Then you can take a claw forceps, you can hold the neck of the gallbladder, and after that you can pull it into the cannula or endo bag, and then it will be taken out. So thank you very much for watching this video. This was just a simple case of laparoscopic cholecystectomy.